I would never disrespect the game and take a player out purposely. He knows that. That's all that matters to me. Praying for a speedy recovery. So, Shannon, I start with you here. Was this play clean or dirty in your eyes?
Skip, it wasn't a dirty play. It was an unnecessary play. And intent only matters to Solomon Hill. LeBron James is still going to be out 3 to 4 weeks. So basically, they play 4 games every 7 days. If he's out 3 weeks, Skip, that's 12 games. He's out a month, that's 16 games. There's what, 30 games left in the season? So there's a potential that LeBron James can miss half of the remaining games. And considering they're only, what, 2.5, 3 games in front of the 6th or 7th spot, there's a chance with AD being out, by the time these guys get back, they can be not only out of the playoff, they can be out of the play-in situation. Because you saw what they looked like last night, and we've seen what they look like without LeBron on the court.
Skip, and Anthony Davis.
Well, if LeBron's there and Schroeder, you can get by. Because LeBron is the guy that – LeBron is the chef. LeBron stirs everything, going to make sure everything's okay. In a situation like this, I don't get why Solomon Hill – Skip, Solomon Hill is not on the second of a 10-day contract needing to impress someone. Solomon Hill's contract was guaranteed in January. Solomon Hill has been around long enough. If this is game 7 of the NBA Finals or the Eastern Conference, Western Conference Finals, mm-hmm. Skip, I get it. But 1 minute into the second quarter, in game 42, you're diving on the floor outside the three-point line? And you're talking about intent. Skip, my good friend Dr. Dyson said the mosquito, his only intent is to draw blood. But in the process of doing that, it might give you Zika. It might give you West Nile. It might give you malaria. That's not his intent. His intent is not to give you those diseases. His only intent is to get blood. So I don't want to hear Solomon Hill, my intent was to get the ball. The intent only matters to you. LeBron James has it hot.
Okay, so clean or dirty?
Skip.
Tell me. Clean. You're saying it's clean, but it's dirty. You're going both sides of your mouth.
No, I'm not. Skip.
Okay, clean or dirty?
Skip, it was not a dirty play. It was not a dirty play. I'm saying it was unnecessary.
What's the difference?
What do you mean, what's the difference?
It's a dirty play. You're saying it's dirty.
Skip.
If it's unnecessary, it's dirty. Like, you should have pulled up and not gone for that basketball. Skip. That's what you just told me.
No, Skip.
You just told me that.
Skip.
You can't have it both ways.
Yes, you can, Skip.
Go for the ball or don't.
The mens rea of it in a situation like this, the mindset, Skip, that's not a dirty play. He's going for the ball. But my point is, in that situation, 1 minute into the second quarter, you're diving on the floor. How many times have we seen Solomon Hill dive on the floor for a ball?
Well, I don't know. How many times do you watch Solomon Hill?
I watch Atlanta because I like Trey Young. So he's not in the game a whole lot. He's just running around shooting three. But Skip, don't try to do that. Don't try to say, well, you can it's a dirty play. No, it was a play. I thought it was a basketball play. Now, he went about it half-hearted. He just didn't dive on the floor, Skip. You could tell. He's going like, I really shouldn't be doing this. And then that's what happens. But my thing is that I don't believe it was dirty because I don't believe his intent going into the situation like, I'm going into the game. I'm going to hurt LeBron. Intent only matters to the person that's committing the act. The person that receives the act is just as injured. It's the difference between murder and manslaughter. Intent matters to the defendant. I mean, the victim is just as dead. LeBron James is just as injured, even though Solomon Hill did not intend for the act to happen.
Okay,
boom.
I'm still not sure I'm getting you on that, but okay. Let me answer the question because I will tell you flat out, not a dirty play.
I didn't
Period.
Say it was dirty.
End of story. Well, I'm answering the question. It's my turn now. And I cannot imagine why Montrezl Harrell would sit up there after the game and say that was a dirty play. That's out of bounds for Montrezl Harrell. Solomon Hill is in his 8th NBA season. He has been on 4 teams. This is his 4th team. But he is playing 20 minutes a game for the Atlanta Hawks,
right,
averaging 4 points and 2 rebounds a game because he fights on defense. That's his calling card. And if we could see this play one more time, you hit the nail on the head at the end of your soliloquy when you said he starts it by causing the potential turnover. He's the one who knocks the ball out of LeBron's hands. And then You're telling me just because it's early second quarter, you're not supposed to dive for the basketball? And the truth is, he did not dive for the basketball. The truth is, he went half-hearted. You use the exact, he pulled his punch. He pulls his punch. It's like, whoops, I'm sorry, LeBron. I don't want to crash against your planted foot and leg, because if you crash, if you go full speed, if you go all the way over, you know what's going to happen? ACL might happen. We can forget about high ankle. We can go to ACL. That was as far from a dirty play as you can get. I don't know about what intent or his intent was to get the damn basketball. That's what he was trying to do, because he's trying to win the damn basketball
game.
Oh,
the second quarter.
Yes, sir. And if the NBA, what does the NBA always get criticized for? They don't play any defense until the last 2 minutes. Baloney, they don't. They play their tails off the whole way through. And Solomon Hill's job is to go on the floor for 20 minutes a night and play his tail off. Way to go, Solomon Hill. And then I heard Schroeder after the game. I watched his whole Zoom interview, and he was defending Solomon Hill, saying we're in the same draft class. I know him. I respect him. There's no way that was a dirty play. And then I don't even know where the quote came from, but later I see on Twitter some quote from him saying, yeah, it was a dirty play. What? It was not a look at him pull his punch. I got to see it one more time. He starts to go down and he's reaching for the basketball, and then he says, whoops, I can't go there. I got to pull back. He pulls his punch. He pulled away. He did not go ahead and fall full weight across the ball. He says, no, I got to stop. I got to pull up. So don't give me dirty play. Skip. I'm sorry. It just happens.
Skip, LeBron said that. I didn't say it was dirty. I said it was unnecessary.
Okay. All right. Well, I don't know what the difference is. You're trying to, like, play both sides of the fence
really,
a little bit.
Hold on, Skip. Really? Skip, you don't know the difference between intent and unnecessary?
I don't. He's just playing basketball. His intent is, I know what his intent is, I got to get the basketball because I dislodged it and I need the steal.
So hold on. So for the past 20 years, you said only the fourth quarter matters. Now 1 minute into the second quarter matters.
I didn't say that. Every second matters.
When LeBron, hold on, no, it doesn't. When LeBron James goes off in the first, second, or third, that doesn't matter. But now
it matters. Do I expect LeBron James to play hard for four quarters? Yes, I do. A defensive specialist, do I expect him to go hard early in the second? You better believe I do, because he doesn't get that many chances. So I am completely defending Solomon Hill. And now let's go to part B of this. So what happens after part A? LeBron rises on the floor, and as Kuzma said after the game, I've never seen such anguish. Right. I've never heard him scream and yell before, right? And I hadn't either. I'd never seen him writhe like this on the floor as long as he writhed on the floor. And yet, knowing him the way that I know him, having followed him as closely as I've followed him, I've seen him get a little melodramatic in these circumstances and pop right up and be Iron Man. He is simply the most durable athlete superstar athlete I have ever remotely covered. There's never been anything about like LeBron James when it comes to durability. So I was not at all surprised to see that he finally got up. For a second, he couldn't put any weight on the right foot. And then, if we can see what happened, he began to walk on the high ankle sprain. And then this happened. We didn't get to see him walk. But then he plays. And right away, what did he do? It didn't surprise me a bit. He gets an open three, and he nails it from the left corner. And then he tried to trot up floor. And he was trotting okay up floor. It didn't look that bad. He wasn't that hobbled. And he got to midcourt, and he stopped and said, you know what? This is ridiculous. I can't go. And then we saw him walking away, and he knocks the chair over. That wasn't because he was mad at Solomon Hill. He was mad at it.
Yeah,
he was mad at the seat. He might lose the MVP.
Right.
He's going to lose some games as he pursues Kareem's all-time record. And he's in year 18, so the clock is ticking to some degree, right?
Yeah.
So he's just mad at it. He's mad that he got hurt.
Oh, Skip, I mean, you're mad at the situation because you're like, damn, I'm playing so good. I found a rhythm. I'm 26-8-8. The team has found a rhythm with our AD. We're playing really well. Skip, let me ask you a question, Skip. The play that Patrick Beverly did on Russell Westbrook when Russell was going to call a 20-second timeout and Pat Bev undercut it. Was that dirty?
Yep. It was.
Why was it dirty?
Because it's breaking an unwritten rule.
Oh, that's an unwritten rule. Not unwritten. Not unwritten.
Okay, was LeBron trying to call timeout?
No, so, hello. What unwritten rule? Is it a rule or isn't it? You talking about both sides.
You know what's the rule? You know what the rule is?
What is it?
You know, you're all over the map. You're going on one side of the fence and the other. Here's the point. It's my turn.
That's the point.
It's my turn.
Go ahead.
The rule is you play basketball as hard as you can play it every second
Patrick
of every
Beverly
game.
Was doing that.
That's the rule.
Patrick Beverly was doing that.
He was not. Russ has got the ball under his arm trying to say, I want
you
to
play hard
out.
Every okay. second. You just said right. you play hard every second. Now, which is it? You're talking about both sides of your mouth.
Oh, stop it.
Exactly. Okay, you know it was unnecessary. It doesn't have to be intense to be unnecessary.
What are you talking about? It is it's 1,000% necessary. It's as necessary as any play Solomon Hill ever made in his life. He's trying to get the basketball. And when he got in precarious situation, dangerous situation, he pulls his punch like, ooh, I can't go there. I'm still trying to reach and get it, but I'm not going to fall full weight across LeBron's planted right leg. Period. End of story.
Hold on. So let me go. Okay, he was like, I'm going to dive for the floor, but midstream, mid-air, I can't do this, so I'm going to half-hearted.
Correct. Used the word half-hearted before I used it.
I'm saying that's
Thank you.
My point exactly.
Thank you. My point exactly.
Hold on. Either you're playing hard or you're not. Either you're going to go all the way or you're going to play half-hearted. What you going
to
do?
You get to a point where you say, I can't put
you
this
You can't do
in
that. No, that's not what you said. Said Solomon Hill's job is to be on the floor for 20
that's
minutes
ridiculous.
And get on the floor. Now you said he can't do that.
Clean or dirty, not dirty.
Skip,
Simple as that.
Skip, nobody
Simple
said
that.
It was dirty.
You said that it was unnecessary. Well, it's the same. It's the same thing. You're saying if it's unnecessary, then it was a dirty play. Right?
So let me ask you a question.
Nobody says it's unnecessary.
Skip, let me ask you a question. When Tom Brady got his knee blown out, was that a dirty play?
Well, they made a rule against
No, that is, that's not what you're the rule. I didn't ask you what, that wasn't a rule at the time. It wasn't a clean or dirty play.
It's falling into a man's planted left foot. Don't laugh. I'm trying to answer the question.
He fell into
You're
a
the
man's
one who looks
foot.
Foolish. I don't. What are you talking about?
I got you trapped, and all you could do is say, you look foolish. You look foolish.
It was unnecessary.
It's my turn.
It was unnecessary, so it's
That's all you could do.
Dirty?
I got you trapped. I just asked you a simple question. Was the play on Tom Brady dirty? And you can't answer it.
What does it have to do with this play right here?
Because it's the exact same thing. It was not dirty. It was not. It was not a dirty play.
Did Brady drop the football?
It was not unnecessary.
Was Tom Brady looking at that man? No, he was looking downfield to throw the football, and I believe the ball was gone.
Skip. LeBron was not looking at him. LeBron was trying to get the ball.
Well, he could feel him. He knew he was coming.
Well, Tom Brady could feel him.
No, he couldn't. He couldn't even see him. He's looking downfield.
Okay, Skip.
Okay, did they not make a rule against that? You think they're going to make a rule against this play?
No, Skip.
You think they will? No, they won't, because
Skip.
It happens every game to everybody.
Skip.
LeBron has been incredibly blessed in his 18 years that hasn't happened to him before.
So LeBron James is the only athlete that's been blessed not to have major injuries.
Well, he's been the most blessed of any athlete I've ever covered.
More blessed than Tom? Tom missed 1 year.
Okay, well,
other than that, that's 20 years.
Okay, Tom doesn't play basketball. You see, basketball is very different from football.
So which is more physical, basketball or football?
Well, obviously, football can be, except for what do you always tell me about the quarterback? It's so easy for him to play until he's 44 because nobody ever hits him.
It is, but I'm just saying, and there have been exceptions, Skip. We've had linemen, offensive linemen, Jackie Slater played 20 years. I think one of the Matthews brothers, both of them mm-hmm. played well into their teens. Mm-hmm. Bruce played 20, and I think Clay played like 17, 18. So it happens. Skip, all I'm saying is, look, I'm not saying it's dirty. See, Skip, when you say dirty intent, I've been with guys where they go into a game with the intent is to injure someone.
Sure.
I understand that, but
okay.
I understand.
Does Solomon Hill have any track
no,
record?
No, Skip.
Not
Skip,
at all.
Skip, because someone does not intentionally do it, that doesn't mean the act could have been avoided. I believe this play could have been avoided. Solomon Hill jumping on the floor with 1 minute left into the second quarter, Skip, that's not going to win or lose the game.
Like win or lose his job.
He's guaranteed, got a guaranteed contract.
For the rest of this year,
yes.
And then what?
So you think they're going to pick his contract up next year?
I don't know.
Probably not.
Okay.
Exactly. There's a reason why he's been on team playing on these one-year
okay,
contracts.
So there's a reason he's going to dive for the loose ball shortly into the second quarter.
Oh my
it's
God.
What he does. It's what he is supposed to do.
All I'm saying is, Skip, in a situation like that. I've seen Schroeder dive for the ball. I just saw him do it the other night against Atlanta. But he doesn't dive in the direction. It's clear path. It's just the ball, and he's diving to prevent the guy from getting it. He's not diving into a crowd because that's what happens. Somebody might be taking a step. Your momentum goes, and then, boom, that's a knee, that's an ankle, and that's what happened. I'm not saying I don't believe Solomon intended to do that, but I just believe it was a necessary act, and whether he intended or not, LeBron James is just as injured, whether he meant to do it or not.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show, and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed, or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.